Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ivy, and if you are new here, welcome. I am a student in an accelerated nursing program, and I'm also a medical assistant in dermatology and cosmetics. So here I like to share all things skincare and also my journey through nursing school. So for those of you who follow me on Instagram, you probably know that I am officially done with my first semester of nursing school, which is so exciting. Thank God I am done because, whew, that was rough. So I decided that I would share with you what my first semester was like, things that I wasn't expecting, some things that I wish I knew prior to starting nursing school, especially an accelerated program, because the speed in which we are going through these classes is insane. I can't believe we're already done. Like, I feel like I just started. Like, we just started this program 4 months ago, and I feel like I know so much, but yet it also feels like I know so little. Like, you know, I'm gonna start with the pace of the program. It is so fast paced. It is crazy how fast it goes. Majority of the students ended up having to quit their jobs because they just couldn't handle juggling both the classes as well as the work hours, so they quit. Some ended up just going part-time and, you know, reducing the hours that they worked, which, to be honest, for the students who are still working, I give them so much respect because personally, I don't think I would be able to handle that. With that being said, I want to emphasize that if you get accepted into an accelerated nursing program, you have to learn time management and you have to stay organized because there's going to be so much information being thrown at you, and it's so easy to feel overwhelmed, especially in the beginning when you're first starting the program. Like, oof. There was a point in the semester where my cohort was so stressed out that we ended up venting to my pathophysiology professor, and she felt so bad for us that she ended up extending one of our exams so we could have extra time to study for it. Because I think there was a week where we just had so many assignments and exams happening all at once. That one act of kindness from her, it made such a huge difference. And I remember there were people who legit started crying because it was like, oh, thank God. Seriously, God bless this professor. I'm saying this because in the beginning, when you're still learning your study habits, when you're still getting used to the routine, like, things can get very overwhelming because there's just so much information being thrown at you. So just stay organized, manage your time wisely, and figure out what your study habits are before you even begin the program, because some of the stuff that worked for you during your undergrad is not going to work for you during the accelerated nursing program. For example, for AMP, I used to use flashcards. I was like a flashcard queen. And now for this program, I cannot do that anymore. It's just too time consuming and I just won't have enough time to study for my other classes. So I can't do that anymore. Speaking about studying, I kind of want to delve into that a little bit more. One of the things that worked for me during my undergrad that still worked for me now was using Notability on my iPad. I feel like Notability and Apple should freaking give me like some kind of a discount or some kind of like pay or something, because I convinced so many of the students in my cohort to get an iPad and to start using Notability. I'm not sponsored, by the way, but I just want to say that Notability is amazing for taking notes. It helped me so much during my science courses in my undergrad when I was taking my prereqs, and it helps me so much during the nursing program. I feel like if you are more of a visual learner, this is definitely something that you should keep in mind. Also, another thing about studying is that everybody in my class knows the material, but this is not like undergrad where you can just regurgitate the material, just like, you know, it's true or false. This is more of like critical thinking. So there are these beautiful questions on these exams called SATA, or Select All That Apply. I swear to God, those are like the devil's work or something, because they are so hard. My class would freak out with our health assessment course, because health assessment was notorious for putting a lot of Select All That Apply questions on our exams. Like, you didn't know exactly what she was asking for, or like, it was one of those things where like technically one of them was correct but it wasn't. So it was very hard, and I feel like, unlike undergraduate courses where you can just study and regurgitate the material, nursing is more of studying the material and knowing it, but then also doing a lot of practice questions just so you can get used to like how these questions are going to be worded and just getting used to that style of questioning. If you guys are in nursing school, I highly recommend you getting this book. It is really good. It gives a lot of practice questions and it summarizes a lot of the material so well. Definitely try and do some practice questions whenever you can. Like, there's a ton of resources online. I think Registered Nurse RN has like some questions on her website as well. So make sure you practice those questions because they are hard and they are definitely going to show up on your exams because they are on the NCLEX and they're basically preparing us to be able to do well on the NCLEX. So just a heads up. By the way, do you guys like that I'm like dressed in nursing attire? I thought I would come prepared, like this is an interview or something. Okay, so moving along about studying, I also want to emphasize that it's important that you make a study group. Try to find a small group of students whom you can study with and bounce ideas off each other, because sometimes they might catch something that you missed or vice versa. And sometimes when you understand the material, explaining it to somebody else who's confused about it only reinforces the material for in your mind. So honestly, it helps everyone. Like, it just, I have two friends who I study with the most and we call ourselves the nerds. If you guys are watching, hi. Also, when I say, you know, make sure you guys can study, like actually study, don't get together and then get distracted and start talking about a bunch of other things. Like, when the three of us get together, we stay on track, we don't get distracted, we work hard, and we get so much stuff done whenever we get together. Like, one of the main reasons why I did so well in Patho was because I studied with my friends. So make sure you get a good study group. All right, so let me talk about clinicals. Clinicals was interesting because in the beginning of our program, we were still kind of like doing things virtually. The school wasn't letting us go to campus and we weren't allowed to go to our clinicals yet. But halfway through the semester, we were finally able to start going to clinicals in person, which was very exciting. I honestly feel so happy and lucky that my class was able to do in-person clinicals, because I know so many other nursing students were unable to do any clinicals. Right now, the nurses are so understaffed in these hospitals. In the beginning, I felt like I was in the way. I was afraid of doing anything because I was scared that I would do something wrong and just put on more work to my nurse. There were times where these students would arrive and you could just tell on the nurses' faces that they just did not want to deal with the students. Like, they already had so much on their plate, they didn't want to have to take care of a student as well. It was a little bit intimidating at first, and I have to admit that in the very, very beginning, I would kind of just stand on the side and just observe, just because there was so much chaos going on that I just felt like if I tried to do anything, I was just getting in the way. But as the semester progressed, I started to get a little bit more confident with like basic things like taking vitals, checking their medication, doing medication administration and things like that. Instead of just standing on the side and observing, I decided to be a little bit more proactive and try and help the nurse in things that I felt comfortable doing. You know, like, I would try and help by getting vitals done first thing in the mornings before breakfast arrived, so that when it came to medication administration, we knew which patients needed what before they started eating. I would go off, take vitals, let the nurses know. I would also help patients with hygiene, bed baths. I would basically just try and do whatever I could to get some work done for the nurse, so that way she had less to do, and it also helped me practice my clinical skills so that I could feel more confident doing them. I remember at one point I was actually able to help in a rapid response. Rapid response team arrived, and of course it was very chaotic. There was a lot of people in the room, so I actually stepped to the side this time because I was like, there is nothing I can do here, let me just observe. But one of the nurses who was a part of the rapid response team actually noticed me standing there, and she was like, "Are you a student?" And I was like, "Yes." She showed me how to work the crash cart. She showed me how to turn on the machines. It was such an adrenaline rush, and I actually loved it. I was so excited to share with my professor that day what happened. And it kind of got me thinking, like, maybe I can thrive in this kind of environment, because I was so excited. I really enjoyed it, and who knows, maybe it's something that I may consider in the future. Also, it's good to be proactive and help the nurses out, because not only are you helping yourself by practicing these clinical skills, but it also shows to your professor that you want to learn, that you want to practice these skills, you know, that you're not just standing around doing nothing. So this is how I actually would dress up for clinicals. Like, I would have my scrubs on, I would have my stethoscope on, my hair is pulled back in a bun. Please make sure that if you have long hair, do not just put it like in a ponytail or something. Try to keep it in a bun, because you are going to be cleaning up bodily fluids. If your hair is long, You don't want your hair getting in there and then it's gonna be picking up who knows what, so put it back in a bun. I have my stethoscope, I have my pen light, which is very important for assessing, you know, patients' eyes and whatnot. I also usually have my pen, and I don't have it with me right now, but I would also have a little notepad to jot down any notes, and that way I can write my care plans when I get home. Another thing I want to mention is to get ready to not have a social life while you're in nursing school. I literally had to kind of like give a disclaimer to my family and friends saying like, if I do not answer your phone calls or your texts, do not take it personally. I'm probably not gonna be able to attend any events or birthdays or anything because I'm going to be too busy with this program. Another thing I forgot to mention about health assessment is that you learn how to do a head-to-toe assessment. At the end of the semester, you are going to be performing one in front of the professor, and you are going to be graded with either a pass or fail, depending on how well you do it. So basically, throughout the semester, you're going to be learning about different body systems and how to assess each one. So at the end of the semester, you have literally learned about every single system in the body, and you will be doing a head-to-toe assessment in front of the professor. You're going to be doing this on another student, and depending on how well you demonstrate your clinical skills, then you're going to either get a pass or a fail. There's no numerical or letter grade. You literally either pass or fail. And the scary part about this is that even if you've been getting straight A's on all of the written exams and lecture, if you fail the head-to-toe assessment, you fail the entire course, no matter how well you are doing in the written exams, and you have to retake the entire thing. With that being said, let me tell you guys, self-care is so important. If you feel yourself getting overwhelmed, definitely take some time for yourself. Just step away for a few minutes, relax, go get some water. You know, make sure that you're also prioritizing your mental health, because trust me, it is very easy to get burnt out in nursing school and your body starts to get sick because of it. Go play with your dog, go watch your favorite show or something, and make sure that you're taking care of yourself. Another thing I want to talk to you guys about are grades in nursing school. They are different compared to the grades in undergrad. I'm sure you guys have heard that the failing grade is a lot higher. A 70 is not passing, a 70 is failing, and failing pretty bad. So I'm very grateful that I finished with a 3.9 GPA, got straight A's except for one class. I got a B+ in one class, and I missed an A by 0.5 points. I was short by less than a point for an A, and my professor refused to round it. So I'm just letting you guys know right now that nursing schools are not gonna round. You get what you get. And like, at the end of the day, it's not a big deal. I know I still did well, but it's just the fact that I missed an A by less than a point just bothered me so much. But I'm just like, you know what, just relax. Like, you did fine, you did great. It's still a great GPA, like you still did great, whatever. With that being said, the reason why I'm saying this is because there are some people who were on the other end of the spectrum where they actually failed the class by less than a point. And again, my professor refused to round, and unfortunately, they will not be moving forward to the second semester with the rest of the cohort and I. So it's very tough. Like, you're not gonna get extra credit, you're not gonna get your grade rounded up. A 75 is considered a C, and you are barely passing, and that is actually kind of concerning because you should be doing much better than that. The professors may actually speak to you on the side. They'll probably advise you to get some tutoring and get some extra help to try and raise that grade up to at least in the 80s. And so far, that is it. I'm starting my next semester in a week, I believe. So we just go straight through. We don't get a summer vacation. We are taking classes throughout the entire summer from June all the way till August, and then we're gonna go straight into the fall semester in September. If there is one takeaway from this video, is to try and stay organized. I cannot stress this enough. Accelerated programs are very fast paced. They are very hard. They are not like undergraduate courses, and it's going to take some time to get used to the pace and the amount of information that is being thrown at you constantly. All right, and that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up if you like it. Subscribe if you enjoy these kind of videos, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!